خَتَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ Allah has placed a seal upon their hearts. But I want to tell you something very beautiful and powerful about this surah. We said, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبُ No doubt, right? Where does doubt rest? It's the heart. هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ هُدًى, guidance. Where does guidance rest? Guidance is also in the heart. Taqwa is where? Taqwa is also in the heart. Then he says, الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبُ Belief, Iman. Where does Iman rest? In the heart. Everything we've been talking about so far is a matter of what? The heart, over and over again. Even kufr, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا Those who disbelieved. Disbelief is where? In the heart. Literally inside the heart. This is where kufr lies. So now everything had to do with the heart. خَتَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ وَعَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِمْ Allah placed a seal upon their hearts and their hearing. So what did He seal first? The heart. The heart He sealed first. Isn't the entire context, the entire subject, didn't it have to do with the heart? It did, didn't it? So when it came to sealing, what did Allah seal first? The heart. Now if you go to Surah Al-Jathiyah, you find something interesting. He says, وَخَتَمَ عَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِ قَلْبِهِ He sealed his hearing and his heart. So what did Allah change? Instead of sealing the heart first, there in Surah Al-Jathiyah, in the 23rd ayah there, in Surah number 45, He sealed what first? He sealed the ears first, the hearing first. How come? This surah seals the heart first, that one seals the hearing first. In Surah Al-Jathiyah, way in the 8th ayah, we learn something. We listen to this ayah. He says, يَسْمَعُ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ تُتْلَى عَلَيْهِ ثُمَّ يُصِرُّ مُسْتَكْبِرًا كَأَنْ لَمْ يَسْمَعْهَا He listens to the ayat of Allah being read onto him. And he turns away in arrogance as though he hadn't even heard them. What was the crime of the disbeliever in Surah Al-Jathiyah? Refusal to what? Listen. So 15 ayat later, when it came to sealing, Allah seals his ears first. خَتَمَ عَلَىٰ سَمْعِهِ وَعَلَىٰ قَلْبِهِ SubhanAllah. How subtle the speech, you know? Even how words are placed, Allah Azza wa Jalla puts perfection in them.